good morning to each and everyone. I greet you all in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Welcome to our Resurrection Sunday morning service. And indeed, it is a blessing, it is a privilege to be alive, to be in the house of the Lord, to celebrate the risen Savior. Amen. Hallelujah. Like to sing on the song, My Redeemer Lives. Let us all stand.
Taken away by pain, by pain. the land of the living, O God. For I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord, to give you praise that you rightfully deserve, O God. We will not allow any stone to cry out to you in our place, O God. We will praise you. We were made to worship, O God. The people of Power and Science Ministry were made to worship, O God. We are worshippers, O God. We are people that are called to praise you, O God. We are people that are called to lift your name on high, O God. We are people that are called, O God, for such a time like this, to be a light into the world, O God. To be a light into this village, O God. We are people that are called, O God, to be a light when we step out of our home, O God. We are people that are called, O God, to be a light when we step into our workplace, O God. Because many, O God, don't know what it is to have a true and living God on their side. But we know, O God. We, the people of Power and Science Ministries, knows, O God, what it is, O God, to have a God who we can call in a time of trouble, knowing, O God, that you are a resurrected Savior. As we are gathered here this morning, O God, into your place, O God, into this place of worship, O God, and to recognize you as a resurrected Savior, not as a Christ that was raised from the dead. No one didn't raise you, O God, but you had the power to lay down your life and pick it up again, O God. So you resurrected, O God, and that's a special kind of power, O God, a special kind of power when some may know you as a miracle worker, some may know you, O God, as the Jesus who was in a manger, but we are privileged this morning to know you as a resurrected Savior, O God. Heavenly Father, the time that was supposed to be the darkest day on the earth, you turned it around, O God. You made it at something different, O God. You said, oh, death, where is thy sting? Oh, grave, where is thy victory? Because from dust we as men came, O God. But you are spirit, so the grave couldn't hold you, O God. And Heavenly Father, this morning, O God, anything that is holding your people down, I speak that the Spirit of God is going to release it. I speak that the Spirit of God is going to break those chains this morning. Heavenly Father, we can't do this without you, O God. We are nothing without the Holy Spirit. So we depend on your Holy Spirit this morning, O God. We depend on you this morning, O God, to make the difference in our life, O God. We depend on you, O God, that when we put our hands to the plow, O God, it will prosper, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus. On that day, O God, when you were to be betrayed, O God, Heavenly Father, you went in as a lamb to the slaughter. But you rose as a lion, O God. And Heavenly Father, we will rise with you, O God. We will rise above every situation that the enemy placed in front of us, O God. We will rise above every problem, O God. We will rise above every financial problem, O God. We will rise above every sickness, O God. We will rise above everything that the enemy takes that he can throw us down, O God. We will live to tell the story, O God. We will live to tell the story, O God. Because we have a God that is lifting us up and carrying us through, O God. We will live, O God. Because you are our son. Heavenly Father, when the world may fail, you will prevail. When things around us may fail, even ourselves, O God, sometimes we put our mind on something, O God, and we fail. But with you on our side, with you in our heart, we will prevail, O God. And I speak life into somebody's situation this morning. This is Resurrection Sunday. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. I speak life into that situation this morning. Because we serve a God that is alive. And alive forevermore. Nothing is impossible for you, O God. Nothing is impossible for you, Jesus. And this morning, O God, we may kneel, we may cry out, or somebody's heart is crying out to you this morning, O God, because we need that atmosphere to shift, O God. Atmosphere shift now in the name of Jesus. Situation turn around now in the name of Jesus. We speak it to turn around now. For too long, that he could uphold the people of Common Science Ministries back. But it's time. More the enemy pull, more that slingshot pull is the further the stone goes. And this morning, more the enemy is pulling you back. You are getting ready to be released under the anointing of the Holy Ghost, under the anointing of God. Somebody's getting ready to be released because we serve our God. that is a resurrected Savior. We turn it around, O God. We speak life into that situation, O God. We speak life into it this morning, O God. Every undecided decision is decided now, because you are a God that said, you have plans to prosper us, O God. Our plans may fail, O God, but your plans, O God, are to see us high and lifted up, O God. No one in this church this morning, the same power that is in this church is going to travel through the online service right now. And everyone on the other side of this church, on the other side of the screen, is going to feel something supernatural. We set the atmosphere this morning, oh God. We set the atmosphere this morning, oh God. And we say, welcome into this place, Holy Spirit. We want to make you feel welcome into Power and Science Ministries this morning, oh God. Heavenly Father, we are called for such a time like this. Bless your service this morning, oh God. Bless your altar this morning, oh God. This altar that is on fire for you will never go dry, will never go cold, oh God. This altar will always be on fire for you, oh God. Everyone that step on that altar, oh God, is going to step into business this morning, oh God. They're going to step into the business with the Holy Ghost this morning, oh God. Heavenly Father, we know that things are not always easy, but use them for your honor and for your glory this morning, oh God. Use them, oh God. Use them, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, bless your pastor this morning, oh God. We know, oh God, that you have a power, anointed fill, press down, shake it together, and running over swimming for your people this morning, oh God. To cut and pierce anything that is not supposed to be in our life. And I'm praying that the Spirit of God will plant that seed that will be preaching that sermon this morning into our hearts, that in due season it will bring forth fruit, oh God. Bless your musicians this morning, oh God. Bless their fingers, bless their hands, bless their feet, oh God. Give them that melody in their heart in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, do something supernatural in this place this morning. The people of Power and Science Ministries are depending on you, oh God. Bless all the visitors, bless all those that are coming in. Bless them, oh God. And let them see that something different is going on in this church this morning. In Jesus' name.
Celebrate Jesus, celebrate. I am at the wind's end, I am at the dead end. But guess what? My God, He specializes in raising from the dead. He is alive and He is here. He is in the midst this morning. Hallelujah. Celebrate Jesus, celebrate.
name. If you have a Hymnal Plus 5, you can follow along. Number 89, entitled Christ's Resurrection. In the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulchre. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. His countenance was like lightning, and his raiment white as snow. And for fear of him, the keepers did shake and became as dead men. And the angel answered and said unto the woman, Fear not ye, for I know that ye seek Jesus, which was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen, as he said. Come, see the place where the Lord lay. And go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. And behold, he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall ye see him. Lo, I have told you. And they departed quickly from the sepulchre with fear and great joy, and did run to bring his disciples word. And as they went to tell his disciples, behold, Jesus met them, saying, All hail. And they came and held him by the feet and worshipped him. Then said Jesus unto them, Be not afraid. Go tell my brethren that they go into Galilee, and there shall they see me. Now is Christ risen from the dead, and become the first fruits of them that slept. Amen.
Same power is available to you and I this morning. So I know that sometimes you go through valleys, you go through situations where we feel like we just don't have the strength, we can't handle the situation, we can't speak, if we can't even step, you know, 1 foot forward again. But you plead the blood of Jesus and the resurrection power of our Lord and Savior, and God is going to give you that strength to make it. In fact, testimonies here today that God has been good to you. He has empowered you, and even when you felt like you don't know how you're going to make it, how you're going to get through, just then God's strength came in. When we are weak, that is when He is strong. When we come to our end, His power has only just begun, because He is powerful. He is the Almighty God. And I suppose it's the agenda this morning. Resurrection Sunday, let us welcome her to give God a note of praise. I know that she is so grateful to our Savior.
Today my heart is filled with joy, happiness, peace, and contentment. I gathered my God went on that cross. The blood of Jesus upon my life that I'm serving in here today. I'm happy for what He has done for me and what He has yet to do for me. I pray to God that my children and the rest of my grandchildren can come to know Him before it's too late. We serve a God that He's alive and He's alive forevermore. We don't serve a dead God. When we're in deepest trouble, we thank God for His secret place that we can go and call upon Him. And He will answer us in His timing. Yeah. He's been good to me. I love Jesus, and I'm serving Him till I see Him face to face. Yeah.
Thank you.
believe it or not, but it's not going to change the fact, it's not going to change the truth that Jesus is alive. Amen. Hallelujah. This time I have a poem. It's going to be read by Simran. So I'd like to call on her this time. So be followed by the choir.
Forever. Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
this morning. I wash in the blood of the Lamb. There is nothing that can wash our sins away, that can wash our filth away, only the blood of Jesus. At this time, let us welcome our little drama team this morning.
Let's intimate.
just getting a little reminder of what took place on that first resurrection morning. Glory to God. Our Savior conquered death and He conquered the grave. Hallelujah. Amen. He went down to hell. Glory to God. And preached, thank you, Jesus, that now there is salvation and now there is hope for mankind. Man does not have to die and go to an eternal hell, but man can live and live with the Lord forever and ever and ever. Amen. Put our hands together for resurrected Savior and our soon coming King. Thank you, Jesus. Please be seated. We welcome every one of you to our Sunday morning worship service and this special Resurrection Sunday. Please send in your prayer requests to those of you who are on our live. We will be praying for you. Today is a great day to send in that request. Amen. Hallelujah. Experience in your situation right now the power of His resurrection. Glory to God. So send it in. We welcome at the same time the newcomers that are among us. We have some brand new worshippers with us. Blessings of you guys. So we have Tracy. Could you lift your hand, Tracy? Blessings on you. Hallelujah. We have Aman. Glory to God. He's right there, my brother. Hallelujah. We all also have Arush. Could you lift your hand, Arush? Blessings on you. And next to Arush, we have Sita. Praise the name of the Lord. We welcome this family. Put your hands together for them. Amen. We also welcome Sister Sherry's son, Jeremy. Could you lift your hand, Jeremy? We're glad you're here to worship with us. And just in case I've missed anyone, I need to do that. Is there anyone that you are first time worshiper? Can I see your hand at the house here? Very good. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, those at the school this morning, because today is a very special day. So we are overwhelmed with joy to have all kids with us, joining with us in the full service. Amen, somebody. But they did a spectacular job with the singing. I was tremendously blessed. Amen. Hats off to our Sunday school department for sharing with us this morning. Put our hands together for them. Teacher, God bless you. You are doing a wonderful job with our children. You have our support. You have our love and our deepest appreciation for all that you do here at Power and Science Ministries. Our choir, we got to say thank you to them as well, because they sang so beautifully, so heavenly this morning. We felt the presence of the Lord. Put our hands together for our choir. God bless you guys. And keep up the wonderful work. I didn't expect a drama today, but we had one. Amen. And they reenacted some of the events that took place on the resurrection morning and also the evening. The disciples summoned Mayas. Amen. As they were talking about the events that took place, and Jesus just came and joined them in. Their hearts were burning. But they did not know it was a resurrected Savior until Jesus was revealed at the supper time. Amen. So we say to all our drama folks today, I love the outfits that you had. Amen. Wonderfully. It took us back 2,000 years ago. So we really appreciate it. It was a surprise to us this morning. So could we put our hands together for our drama team? Absolutely wonderful. They did a splendid job. Well, I've heard that there are baskets for the kids. Alright, I don't know who brought it. Is it anonymous? It got to remain anonymous. Well, whoever you are today, listen, we really appreciate that. Amen. Could I see one of the baskets, please? Do you have it? Could somebody just get to me? Get it to me, amen. So we'll show the church what the kids are getting, a special basket today. Such love in the house, amen, somebody, and appreciation. Now folks, at the corner over there, we have our events corner, and this year our Easter corner is looking even more beautiful than ever before. Again, we really appreciate the team. There is a basket, oh lovely, wonderful, a basket filled with snacks. There's something made with popcorn here as well too. And I've seen chocolates in there, I've seen goodies. This is a lovely basket for all the children. Children, do you see these baskets? Do you want a basket after service? How many of you kids want a basket after service? I know you want it. You got to be on your best behavior today. Amen. I know you are well behaved. Glory to God. But whether you behave or not, you're going to get a basket. Amen. Somebody. So it's something to look forward to. So thank you again. That anonymous person who went to the length to provide this. God bless you so much. Yes. So at our corner here, if you turn around and you can see, it's absolutely beautiful. I love the colors. So many different colors of resurrection. There's no one color, my friend. There are many, many colors. There's gold. There's white for resurrection. Amen. There's blue, like some of us got here, speaking about the righteousness of God. Amen. And white speaks about the holiness of God. Amen. And so many beautiful colors. And we have a kaleidoscope of colors in the house today. Amen. And also at the back, beautiful. Now, please, after church, you can take a picture. Amen. Of your family, of yourself there, and some of you already posted up. I'm seated on Facebook and sharing this special moment. It's not going to be there for very long, so please do this morning. You take your pictures and you share it, and be very kind as Mandisa, our camera lady, amen, is going to be getting you all to take your pictures for that prize tonight, amen. I see some of you have gone all the lengths. Amen. And God bless you so much. At Power and Science Ministries, we are a church that is family oriented. We have a lot of great times at the church here, a lot of fun times. Amen. And so we are glad if you are a newcomer that you can be part of our church family. So we're going to invite Dimitri to come. And for a while now, him and his sister Annabelle has been coming and asking a question from the Bible. And so if you know the answer, please do stand up. Don't shout it on. And you're going to have an opportunity to answer the question and be rewarded with a prize. And so we have a lovely prize here to give out from Annabella. Alright, and this time I see you've got something new, Coca-Cola. I mean, you love Coca-Cola. I know you do. I know you do. Coca-Cola and peanuts is absolutely fabulous. So a lovely, lovely, lovely snack bag. So Dimitri, what question do you have for the church today? Oh, I just love when it's simple. Amen. So, glory to God. And I know everybody does the same as well, too. So I guess we're going to get a dozen people to stand up immediately right now. But I've got to look around. Amen. I've got to look around. I need some help. So would you help Dinesh and you look around with me as well? And look at Dinesh, by the way. Oh, he came on for that prize, boy. He came on for that prize. You could probably win that first prize for in the male category. In the male category. Amen. Hallelujah. I think that the hat, you know, really brought it out. Amen. Where did you get that hat? Oh, Jury gave you that hat. Oh, that is so nice of Jury. And did you give him the hat because it was matching on him better than you? And you're in the outfit. Very, very thoughtful. Praise God. Amen. You know, I just want to give my gold teeth to Sister Priya who got gold this morning. Oh, bless the Lord. So, Dimitri, the ball is in your court, my brother.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Well, it's a very, very simple one,
and I was usually at the stand up to answer.
Right, that's correct.
Who did Moses take from the land of Judah to scout Canaan?
Well, Ryan stood for, am I correct? Then so Ryan stood, then Ariella, and I believe stood third. All right. So, Ryan, you go ahead, because I saw Isa, he stood for, right? Yeah. You all in agreement. Okay, Ryan, so who are the scouts?
This
one. Yeah. Yeah. Right. Said, I'm going to be easy on you guys today, just one. And so he shouted one of the scouts and Caleb. Wonderful. So you have won the prize this morning. God bless you. Really appreciate that. Wonderful. So you learn a lot of your Bible when you come up our time ministry to the question that our brother has been asking. Also this coming Saturday, which is the 15th, at 5:30 p.m., there is a memorial service that the entire church has been invited to. And it's right here at Governor's Road, all right? And it's at the residence of Ramesh and Larry. Their boy passed away suddenly with a heart attack, I believe it was. And it has been really tough for the family up to today to come to terms in his passing away. Just a young man, he wasn't married. How old was Bob Bryan? You've been one of his friends? 33? Wow, so that is a significant number, because that was the age of our Lord passed away. And yes, so everybody's invited 5:30 if you can. That's Saturday forthcoming, right at the house. Our church is in charge of the service, and so we're looking forward to what God will do in that home. And also for those who come as they hear the gospel of our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. We're getting ready to pick up this morning's collection, tithe and offering. We invite the offering bearers, would you come with the baskets as we continue in our worship to the Lord. Could I kindly ask you to stand with me for the collection of the tithe and the offering today? Amen. I'd like to ask Sister Emily if she could come and to be so kind to ask God's blessing as we kick up today. And you also look dashing, Sister Emily. I see your heart is blending so beautifully with your dress. And you would probably get a prize for the most colorful outfit today. Don't you say, church this morning? Full of color. Amen. As we take up the dollar.
To be in your house, O God, to worship, dear God, and to praise your God for that sacrifice you made for us, dear God. And Father God, in keeping with that sacrifice, O God, help us to do our part, O God, to give you that sacrifice of praise, O God. To give me offering, O God, in time, Father God, in Jesus' name, O God.
Amen.
For your honor and glory, dear God, yes. In Jesus' holy name. Father, we pray, O God, as we stand there praising you and thanking you, dear God, that you will bless us, dear God.
Praise.
Bless us as we give all our time and offering unto you, Father God, in Jesus' name.
Yes.
We pray, God, for those who don't have, dear God, that you will bless them.
Amen.
Provide for them, Father God, in Jesus' holy name.
Yes.
And that you will take charge and control over everything today, Father God, in our lives, in Jesus' mighty name, O God. We pray, amen.
Amen. Praise God. I see the King of glory coming on the clouds with fire, the world's joy. Jesus. I see His love and mercy washing over all our sins. The people sing, the people sing. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the house. praise the Lord in the house. Can somebody lift your hand? Can somebody bless the name of the Lord? Can somebody shout? Hallelujah. Hosanna. Hosanna in the highest. Glory to God. Oh, we bless your name, Lord. We praise your name. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus Christ. Glory to God. With us the word of the Lord today. Amen. This passage of scripture is talking about the day Christ rose from the grave, a day like today. Amen. Together now, please. In the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulchre. And behold, there was a great earthquake. For the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. His countenance was like lightning, his raiment white as snow. And for fear of him, the keepers did shake and became as dead men. And the angel answered and said unto the woman, Fear not ye, for I know that you seek Jesus which was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen, as he said, Come, see the place where the Lord lay, and go quickly and tell the disciples that he is risen from the dead. And behold, he goeth before you in the Galilee. There shall you see him. Lo, I have told you. And they departed quickly from the sepulchre with fear and great joy, and did run to bring his disciples word. And as they went to tell his disciples, behold, Jesus met them, saying, All hail! And they came and held him by the feet and worshipped him. Then said Jesus unto them, Be not afraid. Go tell my brethren that they go into Galilee, and they shall they see him. From a funeral to a festival. Amen. Somebody. Glory to God. From a funeral to a festival. Amen, somebody? Amen. From Good Friday, with which our Lord Jesus Christ died, to Sunday morning, from a funeral to a festival. Because Resurrection Sunday has to do with the greatest celebration upon planet Earth. Not only, brother, there was celebration down here, but there was celebration in heaven. Glory to God. And I tell you, it has only begun. Because when we get there to the other side, the festival will continue, my friend. Because we will celebrate for the ceaseless ages of eternity, the risen Savior, our Savior, Jesus. Bow with me in prayer. Father, we thank you for resurrection morning. And for the saints that have gathered to praise your name, and for those who are on the live, bless the message in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. You may have your seats. To begin with, I want to share with you a story about a man. His name was George. And so George went on a vacation to the Middle East, to Jerusalem. And he had with him his loving wife, and he also had with him his mother-in-law. But during their vacation in Jerusalem, tragedy struck the family because his mother-in-law, she died. So with the death certificate in hand,
George went to the American consulate officer to make arrangements to send the body back to the United States for a proper burial. Well, the consul told George that to send the body back to the United States for burial is very expensive. And so George asked, well, how expensive it is? And so he was told it will cost him as much as $10,000 to return his mother-in-law's body back. So the consul told him and said, listen, in most cases, my friend, the person responsible for the remains normally decides to bury the body right here in Jerusalem, and you can save tons of money by doing that. And so he asked, well, how much would it cost to do it right here? And he said, only $1,000. Well, George thinks about it for a moment, and then he gave his answer. He said to the consul, I don't care. I don't care how much it will cost to send my mother-in-law's body back to the United States. That's what I want to do. But the consul said, listen, you impressed me, my friend. You really impressed me by what you want to do. You must love your mother-in-law so very much, considering the price that you're willing to pay to send her body back. And George said, it's not that, my friend. So what is it? He said, well, you see, I know a case many years ago that a man was buried right here in Jerusalem. But on the third day, he rose from the dead, and I ain't taking that chance with my mother-in-law. Amen. The resurrection is real. Amen, somebody. Amen. Glory to God. The resurrection of Christ is real. One day, in the year 1932, there was a pastor. His name was Alfred Ackley. And he held an evangelistic meeting where he spoke about Jesus. There was a young Jewish man, mind you, a Jewish man, in the audience. And during one of their conversations, the young man asked the question, why should I worship a dead Jew? Speaking about Jesus. Why should I worship a dead Jew? Well, in today's politically charged times, such a question would probably start an argument. At least a long-heated and defensive exchange would take place. But Ackley could see the sincerity in the young man's heart and a loving, enthusiastic response he was going to give to him. Not at all, bringing down this young man. And so the preacher said, I'll tell you why. And the answer is, this Jew that you are talking about, this dead Jew that you are talking about, he ain't dead, he lives. I tell you, he lives. He ain't in the grave, he rose from the grave. Amen. And more than that, Jesus Christ lives in the hearts of all those who have come to faith and trust in him. He said, I'll tell you what, young man, I'll prove that to you by my own personal experience. I could tell you, amen, what the changes that Jesus Christ has brought in my own life. Amen. Hallelujah. I can testify, not only myself, but I know that there are testimonies of thousands and tens of thousands of people all over the planet Earth. Amen. That this Jew that you are talking about is dead, and he lives in their hearts, and the changes that he has made, the transformations that he has made, cannot be denied. A dead person cannot make that change, my friend. It is only one who is alive, and Jesus Christ is alive, praise God. Hallelujah. Not long after Ackley was on his way home and preparing for the Easter service when he heard another preacher. In fact, it was a famous radio preacher from New York and came to the radio. And he was astonished at the message that this preacher, this popular preacher, was giving on the air. And so the preacher said on the air, good morning, it's Easter, you know, folks. It doesn't really make a difference to me if Christ be risen or not. Far as I am concerned, in the body, his body could be dust somewhere in a Palestinian tomb. The main thing is that his truth is matching on. But my friend, that preacher athlete, he was so incensed by the message that he had heard on the radio and going out to countless persons on the airways. And the preacher shouted and said, "It is a lie. It is a big lie." And his wife heard the ruckus and asked him, "What's wrong, honey? Why are you shouting it's a lie?" And he said to his wife, "Did you hear what that preacher just said on the radio? That good for nothing preacher? Did you hear what he said?" He delivered his message that Easter day, my friend, the preacher. But at night still, he was still agitated. And his wife finally challenged him to do what he did best, and that was to write songs. Amen. And so the scriptures the preacher used to prepare his message, the testimony of the innumerable cloud of witnesses. The Bible says at one point in time, Jesus appeared to 500 persons. We are talking about post-resurrection appearances, my friend. 500 people at one time. It just was one or two. It was just a Mary, my friend, or a couple of disciples. No, there were hundreds of persons that saw Christ in his resurrected form. And so the burning in the preacher's heart came together in the form of lyrics and music. And he wrote the words of this great and famous hymn, "He Lives." Amen. And we are still singing that, yes, later. We are still singing it today, glory to God. You know, it's kind of funny, amen, how after so many decades, much has changed. These days, you will hear on the radio, on the television, commentators, and even theologians, and so-called, I would say, clergy talk about Jesus. He is just a Jewish philosopher. And he is nothing more. To others, Jesus is just a prophet. That's what the Muslim believes. He is just a prophet and nothing more. They put him in the same category as ancient philosophers and classify his ministry as no different than other religious movements that exist in the world today. But for those who know Jesus Christ personally, like us in Cowan Science Ministries this morning, amen. For those who serve Jesus, glory to God, my friend, they experience not a 2,000-year-old religious movement, but what you experience, glory to God, is the transforming power of Almighty God. You experience the filling and the anointing of the Spirit of God. You feel renewed every day. Hallelujah. Praise God. For us, we feel his mercy. For us, we know his care. For us, we experience his guidance. Glory to God. For us, in the time of death, we experience his comfort. In the time of sorrow, amen. Jesus is there. Glory to God. Jesus is there, glory to God. Hallelujah. In the times of trouble, he is there, praise God. Oh, what's the difference, I ask you, between a follower of Christ and a follower of other philosophical religious movements today? I tell you, glory to God. The difference is that every religious philosopher and teacher of a movement has died, my friend. They are all dead. They are all buried. Their bodies have been turned to dust. They have been decayed, my friend. But I tell you, Jesus Christ, glory to God. The scripture says you will not suffer this Holy One to see destruction. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus rose. The stone was rolled away. The tomb is empty. Amen. And that is the difference. Give him praise, somebody. that stone was rolled away. The angels spat on that stone. Amen. Death, praise God, has been conquered. Could I hear amen, somebody? Praise God, the grave has been conquered. The grave does not have the final say over the child of God. Amen. Every time I stand doing a funeral, every time I commit a body to the ground of a believer in Christ, there is the hope of the resurrection. The day is coming soon. Amen. The trumpet of the Lord will sound, the Bible says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. And the dead in Christ will be raised. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. You know why? Why the grave gonna have to give up the dead? You know why even the cremation gonna have to give up the dead? You know why the seed gonna have to give up the dead? Because Jesus rose from the grave, and because He is risen, amen. The resurrection of the saints is going to take place, and the devil can't stop it, and the demons can't stop it. It's about to happen. Praise God! It's about to happen. This morning, thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Sin dominion is broken because the stone has been rolled away. Satan has been defeated because the stone has been rolled away. The captive has been set free because the stone is rolled away. The chains have been broken because the stone is rolled away. Praise God. If you are still chained today, I tell you, my friend, this morning is the morning for deliverance and victory, because the stone has been rolled away. Glory to God. Because the stone has been rolled away, we have hope. Praise God in Jesus Christ. Because the stone has been rolled away, my friend, I believe, despite of what is happening around me, the despair, the confusion that is all around me, because the stone is rolled away, I can lift my head up high. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I know, my brother and sister, that nothing in this world can defeat me. No circumstance can defeat me. Praise God. No trouble can defeat me, my friend. Whatever is happening today, because the stone is rolled away, and my Savior has risen from the grave. Give Him praise today, somebody. The best part of all it is a habitude of life. Amen. Amen. That's the best part, and heaven is mine until I'm home. Let's join with Pastor Acklin in that song. 9 decades ago, was written, amen, to all the philosophers and skeptics, my friend, and the haters of Christianity today, about who Christ is, amen, and was. Glory to God, our silver risen Savior. Let's sing to the Lord today.
A silver risen Savior is in the world today, and know that He is living, whatever men may say. I see His hands of mercy, hear His voice of truth, and just the time I need Him, He's always there.
Come on!
He lives, Christ Jesus lives today, and He walks with me, and talks with me, along side narrow way. He lives, salvation here in You ask me how I know He lives. He lives within my heart.
In all the world around me,
in all the world around me, I see His love in Him. And though my heart grows weary, I never will despair. I know that He is leading through all the stormy blasts. The day of His appearing will come at last. He lives, Christ Jesus lives today, ask me how I know he lives. He lives within my
reason to rejoice now.
Rejoice, rejoice, O Christian, and find your voice and sing eternal hallelujahs to Jesus Christ the King. The hope of all who seek it, the help of all who find it. The mother is so loving, so good. Along like narrow wind, he lives, and salvation to impart.
You ask me how I know
he lives, and he lives within my heart.
Glory to God, my friend. The Easter story does not end at the cross. Amen. It does not end at the whipping. It does not end with the nails. Come on, somebody. It does not end with the thorn of prongs. Hallelujah. But my friend, glory to God, it ends with a celebration. It ends with a festival because he rose from the grave. Amen. I tell you, it demands not just our applause, but it demands our allegiance, because Christ proved that he is the Lord. Amen. He proves, glory to God, that he is the eternal one, the one sent from the Father up above. Praise God. Amen. It demands not just our compliments, but our capitulation, my friend. It demands our complete surrender. If Christ rose from the grave, my friend, I tell you today, it brings us now to our knees, like the woman, like the disciples, and fell down and worship him. Glory to God. It brings us like Thomas. Christ rose from the grave. He said, unless I go see that difference, you guys could say that you have seen him. You must have seen a vision. You must have seen a ghost. Because a lot of people, after people tend to say they've seen the spirit. You must have seen Jesus, the spirit. But my friend, Thomas said, if I do not put my own finger, I want to put my finger where the nails were driven through his hands. I got to see it and I got to feel it. I got to touch it. I was there. I saw him be nailed. I saw the soldier put that spear through his side. If I don't touch that wound that he got, I will never believe that he is risen. But Jesus, the Bible tells us, amen. When Thomas and the disciples were present now in that locked room, he went through that room, my friend, because doors can hold back the resurrected Savior. Are you listening to me, somebody? My friend, for you who know Jesus, no door can keep your blessing this morning, somebody. Come on, no man can keep your blessing. No devil can keep your blessing. Praise God, hallelujah. God's gonna come through any wall for you. He's gonna come through any door for you today, my friend. He's gonna come through for you in your problem, in your need, in your crisis, in your hardship. Glory to God. He's gonna come through when no man could come, when no one could get to you, when nobody understands, and nobody needs, and nobody cares. My Jesus will come through for you. Glory to God. Jesus appeared in the midst of the disciples, and specifically, my friend, Jesus heard what Thomas was saying, amen, because it proves that he is God. There's so much of evidences in the Bible that proves who Christ is. Glory to God, amen, hallelujah. Praise God. How could Jesus possibly knew, my friend, what Thomas was saying, and he wasn't there physically present? Because he is God, he is omniscient. He knows all things. Glory to God. He knows your secret thoughts this morning. He knows what is in your heart this morning, my friend. He knows it all. He said, Thomas, I heard you talking. I heard you saying that if you do not put your finger in the nail prints, you're going to believe I heard you talking, Thomas. If you don't put your finger to the side of that Roman soldier thrust that spear, you're not going to believe that I'm risen. Well, come on now, Thomas. Come on now. Come on, I want you to come here and to put your hand, put your finger in the nail print of my side and see it in those spirit. But it is me, the resurrected Christ, in present, in person, glory to God. Oh, Thomas came, my friend, and when Thomas saw the evidences, when he felt the evidences, the only conclusion that Thomas could conclude that day, he bowed down and he said, "My Lord and my God." Thank you, Jesus. What did Thomas say? "My Lord and my God." Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. If you need any further evidence of Jesus Christ was my friend, he is Lord and he is God. He is Lord of Lords and he is King of Kings. Jesus Christ, give him praise this morning. Oh, bless God. Amen. Today is Easter Sunday, isn't it? As Christians, we gather to celebrate the resurrection of our Savior Jesus Christ. We celebrate that he is not in the grave. Amen. We celebrate he is risen. Hallelujah. Death has conquered the best of men throughout human history. Death has conquered the greatest men of human history. For thousands of years, man has often lived in the fear of death. But there is a message on this resurrection morning, glory to God, hallelujah. There's a message of the empty tomb that Christ has conquered the most and the greatest fear of man. The greatest enemy of man has been fear of death, my friend. But Jesus Christ came on that resurrection morning and he conquered the enemy, the fear of death. The Bible says he took from Satan, he took from our enemy, he took from death the very keys, amen, that will hold man there forever and ever and ever, chained to eternal darkness. He took the keys in Revelation chapter 1 and verses 18 and shut it out. He said, "Look, I've got the keys," amen. That's why he went to hell, the Bible says, and he preached there. In so doing, he got the keys, amen. He took the keys that had conquered man, Paul, he says. He took the keys, he said, "No, amen. The keys of hell and of death, praise God, and I am alive forevermore. You do not have to fear it anymore, praise God." Oh, thank you, Jesus. There was a missionary in Brazil, and he discovered a tribe of Indians in a remote part of the jungle. And so they lived near a large river, and the tribe needed medication. Yes, they needed a medical attention. And so there was a contagious disease that was spreading across this tribal village. People were dying like that all around, and they badly needed the medicine. They needed help. And a hospital was too terribly far away so that they could get over there for treatment. But the worst part was across the river. And the Indians would not cross that river because they believed that in that river there were evil spirits that lived in that river. And so to enter into that river, to go for any help, if it was even possible, it would mean certain death to them. The missionary explained how he had crossed that river. He explained to them and said, "Listen, I'm on hand. I'm telling you, you don't need to fear the river. I have crossed that river personally." But they were not impressed at all. Then he took them and said, "Come, I'll show you." He took them to the bank and he said, "Look what I'll do. I'll show you not to fear the river. Look, I'll put my hand in that river and show you there's nothing to fear." He put his hand in the river, but still they wouldn't go in at all. And then he walked up in the water up to his chest and he said, "Look, see, I'm in that water. You have nothing to fear." But still, my friend, it didn't matter to those Indians. They were afraid to enter into the river. But finally the missionary dove into the river and he swam beneath the surface until he emerged on the other side. And he raised a triumphant hand into the air. Glory to God. Hallelujah. My friend, and he proved to those Indians that they had nothing to fear. My friend, lift their hands, the Indians, hallelujah, into a chair, and they gladly followed the missionary, praise God, because he showed them by his own diving into the river, there was nothing to fear. But 2,000 years ago, there was a man, Jesus Christ, hallelujah, he entered into the river of death, my friend, and defeated man's arch enemy, glory to God, and he rose from the grave triumphantly, praise God, and he lives forevermore. So you don't have to fear death anymore. Somebody, it has no power over the child of God. Amen. The resurrection says that we are recreated in Christ Jesus. Amen. He has paved the way to eternal life. Jesus said in John 5:24, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that heareth my word and believeth on him that sent me hath everlasting life and shall not come into condemnation, but is passed from death unto life, praise God, because of the resurrection. Hallelujah. The story of told of an old pastor, his name was Warren Chandler, and about after whom the school of theology at Emory University was named. So he was a great man. He lay on his deathbed, and a friend inquired now of this great theologian. He inquired about whether or not he was afraid to die, afraid of death. Please tell me frankly, said, you're my friend, I want you to be honest. I mean, you have been a Christian a long time. You have a Bible school, a seminary named after you. You are a very prominent person in the Christian arena. But now it comes time to die. Tell me honestly, are you afraid to die? Are you afraid of crossing the river of death? And the pastor said, why? Why? Why should I be afraid? Because I'm a father who owns the land on both sides of the river. Could I hear amen, somebody? I have a father who owns both sides of the river. We have a God that owns the both sides of the river, my friend. Glory to God. Do not be afraid, amen, of that crossing. Psalm 23 verses 4 says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. The Apostle Paul was afraid of death. In 2 Timothy 4 verses 6 to verses 8, as the axeman was about to take his head off, my friend, he was martyred because of his faith in the Lord. In prison, he said, I am ready to face the axe. I am ready to face the executioner. I am not afraid of the axe. I'm not afraid of losing my head. I'm not afraid of losing my life. He said, I am ready. Hallelujah. Take me now because I am ready. The time has come for me to depart. He said, I fought a good fight in verses 7. He said, I finished my course. I've kept the faith. Henceforth, in verse 8 says, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day. And not only to me, but for all those who love his appearing. Why could Paul say these words, my friend? It is because he had a personal encounter, amen, with Jesus, praise God. While traveling at chapter 9 in the road to Damascus, before he was saved, he was that old Saul, and he was apprehending Christians and imprisoning them. He was responsible for the death also of Stephen. But the Bible tells us now, as he was headed to Damascus to continue his evil work in apprehending more Christians and imprisoning them and bringing them to Jerusalem, the Bible tells us there was a light that shone brighter than the noonday sun, my friend. What was that light? Who was that light? From that light, a voice came out to him, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting? came thou be? He said, who are you that is speaking to me? And the voice said, I am Jesus, glory to God. Hallelujah! I am Jesus, amen, whom you are persecuting, glory to God. You see, my friend, amen, Jesus appeared to Saul, glory to God. He had a first-hand experience and encounter of the risen, resurrected Savior. That is why he could lay down his life. If Christ did not raise from the dead, do you think that Paul would have been willing to give his life for a dead man, my friend, for a dead a Jew? No, sir, my friend, because he knew that Jesus Christ was alive, praise God. He said, amen, I am willing to die, glory to God, because I know, amen, hallelujah, the death does not have power over me. To be absent from this body, Paul says, is to be present with the Lord. Can you say amen, somebody? Now in our text, Jesus made an appearance to many, but to Mary Magdalene. I focus a little bit today that resurrection morning. When he appeared to her, she thought it was the gardener. Mark chapter 16, also John chapter 20, give some more details of the account. But how fitting it was that this woman was first chosen to see Christ in his resurrected, not even his disciples were privileged enough, but this woman, I tell you why, my friend, because she was most grateful, praise God, amen. God is always looking for a grateful heart and a thankful heart, my friend, amen. If you're going to serve Jesus this morning, don't complain, come on somebody. Don't make a fuss, don't make it a problem to serve Jesus, come on somebody. Don't fuss about how I'm going to get here. Don't fuss about service taking too long, belly grumbling, I want to go home. Don't fuss, my friend, amen. What God looks for is a grateful heart and a thankful heart, glory to God, amen. It's much loved by the Lord, amen. You see, my friend, she was possessed with seven devils. She was possessed by evil spirits, and Jesus delivered her. As a result, she never left Jesus' side. She never backslid, my friend. She stayed with the Lord from that moment of deliverance until that cross. She was present there, my friend, at the cross as well. In fact, of her own substance, the Bible tells us in Luke chapter 8, verses 2, she supported the ministry of Jesus financially. This woman, Mary, who's Jesus cast out seven devils from her. But the third day after Jesus' death, early that Sunday morning, she and two other women came to the tomb, the Bible says. And where Jesus was lying to further anoint the body of Christ, because Nicodemus, and Joseph of Arimathea, two men took charge of the body. They went to Pilate and they begged for the body of the Lord. Nicodemus, you must understand, is very significant, because in John chapter 3, there was a man, a ruler of the Jews, that came to Jesus by night. Nicodemus was his name. And Nicodemus wanted to know, amen. He wanted to know about being born again. He wanted to know, amen, about receiving eternal life. And Jesus told him, verily, verily, I say unto you, Nicodemus, that you must be born again, amen, to enter into the kingdom of God. He was thinking about going back into his mother's womb and taking a rebirth. He said, no, that which is born of flesh is flesh, but that which is born of spirit is spirit. Nevertheless, see your children, verses 7-3. He says, you must be born again. From that day, Nicodemus, my friend, amen, became a believer in Jesus Christ. He defended also the Lord during that time, my friend. He stood up for Jesus as a believer in Christ. Glory to God. And now when Jesus died, he took the initiative, amen, and Joseph, his friend, got together, amen, and got the body of Jesus, and wrapped the body in spices and aloes and all of that in the linen cloth. But it was not finished. Because why? Because the Sabbath threw him there and they couldn't complete the embalming process. And so these women came early Sunday morning after the Easter, and they came after Saturday morning, the Sabbath rather, they came to complete the embalming. But lo and behold, my friend, glory to God, hallelujah, they found an empty tomb, amen. What did they find, brother? They found an empty tomb. Amen. They found, hallelujah, the stone was rolled away. They ran to tell the disciples about what they had seen, an empty tomb. Peter and John responded. The first disciples, when they heard the news, they said, we got to see for ourselves. We're not going to believe the words of these women. We're going to see for ourselves. And sure enough, when they came, Jesus' body was gone, my friend. They were confused and wondered what had happened to it. They didn't steal the body away, my friend. Jesus' body was gone. And so they all returned home with the others to spread the news and to talk about what was happening. But there's one person that stayed at the tomb. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. And that was Mary. And she was outside and she was crying. And while she was doing that, the Bible says there were two white-robed men asking her, what was wrong? What was wrong? She said, somebody has taken my Lord away. It was angels. Somebody was taking my Lord away. And I don't know where he is. But then she glanced over her shoulder and saw something that she thought was the gardener. And the voice came to her, why weepest thou? When she said, he asked her, what are you looking for? She said, sir, do you know where they took the body of my Jesus? Do you know where they have taken him? And Jesus answered to her, hallelujah. She thought it was the garden, was Jesus. And Jesus called the name and said, Mary. From the time that Jesus called her name, amen, she recognized and knew now it was Jesus. She answered, Rabboni, which is Master. And Jesus said, don't touch me, because I have not sent it to my Father which is in heaven. And she ran and told the other disciples the news that Jesus Christ is alive. Amen. Praise God. 2,000 years now, brothers and sisters, many have taken a trip to the Holy Land, and you can if you want as well too. But my friend, you're going to find the tomb. It is day up to the day, glory to God. You will find the burial place of Jesus. But what you would find, you would not find his remains. You cannot find it, glory to God, because it's a testament that he rose from the dead. Give him praise, somebody. Oh, thank you, Jesus. In 1887, 22 years after the assassination of one of the presidents of the United States, President Abraham Lincoln, his coffin was dug up and was opened because there was constant rumors that his body was not in the grave. It was just a hoax, a made-up story. So they dug it up, and guess what? The president's body was there. But still, the rumors continued. 14 years after that, guess what? They dug it up again the second time. Both of these times there were witnesses present to testify that the body of the president is still in the grave. But my friend, the big difference between the president Lincoln of United States and Jesus, whereas you can find the remains of Lincoln, you cannot find the remains of Jesus, praise God, because he ain't there, praise God. You will find of great kings and conquerors, you will find the remains of great leaders, and you'll find the remains of great prophets, my friend. You will find the remains of Confucius and Buddha, and even the great prophet Muhammad. You will find their remains, but you cannot find the remains of Jesus Christ, hallelujah, because he is the only one that conquered death and the grave. He's the only one that has power, glory to God. and 186 years after the death of this great Emperor Charlemagne, officials of the Emperor to reopen Charlemagne's tomb, and before them was an extraordinary sight. In the midst of all the finery buried with him, the gold and the jewels and the precious treasure, there was a skeleton of this great Emperor Charlemagne himself, sitting on the throne that they had buried him on. And he is still wearing his crown, but on his lap they laid the Holy Bible. But my friend, his bony finger down was pointing at a specific verse in the book of Mark chapter 8 and verses 36. And what shall a man give in exchange for his own soul? Praise God. You see, as great as he was and as wealthy as he was defeated by death, my friend. Death took him, and his skeleton remained on that throne they had made for him, but not my Jesus. Hallelujah. That stone could not hold him back, and the grave could not hold him back. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. I say to you today that if you ask the great president for help, there will be no answer this morning. There will be no response, because he is dead. Are you listening to me, somebody? Glory to God. If you cry out to the scientists of the world that have died, Einstein, one of the greatest of them all, and you cry out to Einstein and says, hear me, you will hear no response, my friend. Because why? Because he is dead. If you call out to the Caesars, there will be no response because they are dead. If you call out to Alexander the Great, there will be no response because he is dead. If you call out to Muhammad, there will be no response because he is dead. If you call out to Buddha, there will be no response because he is dead. If you call out to Gandhi, there will be no response because he is dead. But if you call out to Jesus Christ, hallelujah, he will answer you. He said, call in Jeremiah 33:3, and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things that you know other. My friend, the dead cannot answer your call. It's only the living can answer your call. Praise God, amen. That's why I do not pray, my friend, amen. I do not pray to no statue. I do not pray to no painting. I do not pray to no wall. Come on, somebody. I pray to Jesus, because he is alive, amen. Give him praise this morning. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. There are billions today that say that Christ did not die and raise from the dead. Many claim that there is no resurrection from the dead. The skeptics of the world, the false religion, says that Jesus simply fainted on the cross. And when he was placed in the tomb, the cool air revived him, and therefore there is no resurrection. The devil, my friend, hate the resurrection. Come on, somebody. You see this service? This service, the devil is cringing, my friend. Wherever the resurrection message like this is being preached, whether it be in cathedrals like this, whether it be in forests, wherever believers are gathered together, my friend, the devil is cringing because he knows the power of the resurrection. He knows what defeated him was the resurrection. Praise God. He don't like resurrection messages. And so, my friend, he has sent out and instigated lies. Lies, I tell you. And it has been praised by religions and powerful religious people today, just trying to discredit the resurrection of Christ, my friend. And they say that he simply fainted on the cross and revived in the tomb. The theory is called a swoon theory, my friend. So they ignore the fact of some evidences, and there are many today. The Roman soldiers, as they came to break the legs of the two thieves and Jesus Christ, to hasten the death. That's a common practice that the Romans, they'll come with clubs. And so while they are suffering on the cross and death was prolonging, what the Romans will do was to take that club and literally break the legs of those that were crucified, so that their legs could not hold them up, and they would suffocate to death, and death would come upon them. But the Bible says they came to the first thief, and they broke his leg because he was alive. They came to the second thief and they broke his leg as well because he was alive. But when they came to Jesus, the Bible says they did not break his legs. Because what? They saw he was dead, my friend. Now let me tell you this. These were people that have crucified thousands of criminals and prisoners, my friend. And they are seasoned in crucifixion. And they knew for well when somebody was dead, my friend. And when they came to Jesus, they saw he was dead and did not break. But that's a fulfilled prophecy. Not one of his bones were broken. That's on the Passover. I preach on the Passover Friday night, my friend. They would have killed that lamb. They would have eaten that roast the flesh and eat the flesh. And they would have taken the blood sprinkled over the doorpost. But the Bible says not a bone was supposed to be broken from those lambs. Specifically, they were commanded, you will not break a bone. Because why? Amen. Not a bone of Christ would be broken. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. And so, brothers and sisters, hallelujah. A Roman soldier took a spear. Listen carefully. A Roman soldier took a spear. When he saw Jesus was dead, you can imagine, my friend, the hatred that they had for Christ because he was heralded as a king. And so he took that spear and he ran that spear into Jesus' side, my friend. The Bible tells us as he ran that spear into Jesus' side, two things came out. One was blood and the other was water. Now these are two important aspects of Jesus' death. Because the blood that came out of Jesus' side, it spoke of the redemptive aspect, amen, of salvation. And the water that came out next spoke of the life imparting aspect of salvation. Praise God. They both play a vital role in our salvation. Because the blood cleanses us from all sin. And the water imparts new life. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. But prior to death, the sustained rapid heartbeat caused by the hypovolemic shock also caused fluid to gather in the sac around the heart and around the lungs. And this gathering of fluid in the membrane around the heart is called pericardial effusion. And so the fluid gathering along the lungs is called pleural effusion. And this explains why after the Roman soldier had thrust the spear in Jesus' side, piercing his lungs, piercing his heart, blood and water came from his side as recorded in the book of John's Gospel. Praise God. Hallelujah. My friend, I could keep on going about the evidences and the fact that Jesus really died, my friend. Even today, the Muslims deny the death of Christ, my friend. They said he had died. Why? Why would you deny such a thing? Because the resurrection didn't happen. If Jesus did not die, the resurrection, of course, is God. There's no resurrection, my friend. But try how hard that they might, my friend. That's why even Muslims today, as I'm preaching today, all over the world, my friend, Jesus is appearing to them. And they're seeing Jesus in their dreams. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Because this is going to be denying the risen, resurrected Christ, my friend. But no matter how much people might deny, one day closing, and I'm going to close on my sleep at time. One day closing, you're going to see that same Christ sitting on the throne, the great white throne judgment. And do you know what you're going to see, my friend? You're going to see the nail prints in his hand. Listen, they're going to be there forever. They're going to be there forever. We're going to see the nail prints. We're going to see the scar on the side. It's going to be there as a testimony, amen, about what the Lord Jesus did for us and how he rose from the grave. And for all those, whether pundits or priests or politicians, I say to you all today, you are denying who Jesus Christ is and denying that salvation is only by Christ. One day, the Bible says in the book of Philippians chapter 2, verses 8 and 9, and verses 10, the Bible says every knee is going to bow and every tongue is going to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. The choice is yours right now. Even you bow to Christ now, my friend. And be saved and have your sins forgiven. And heaven be your eternal home. For either you will bow on that day, but no salvation will be provided. Because the Bible says in Hebrews 9:27, It's appointed unto man once to die, and after this there is a judgment. There is no repentance. No repentance after that. The Jehovah's Witnesses, I feel just to keep on continuing, but amen, hallelujah. But I gotta say this, amen, church, amen. There's a new doctrine of the Jehovah's Witnesses now. They keep changing, I tell you, like they were. They know which one to stand on, my friend. Oh my goodness. Wow. Now they're coming and telling you, recent new doctrine is that you have a second chance after you die. Yes, you have a second chance to repent after you die. Big lie, my friend. Big lie. The only time you have to repent is now. Not after you die. That's a big lie, my friend. It's time for you to make a decision for Christ, for heaven, for eternity. Bow with me in prayer. If you have never made your decision for the Lord, for Christ, I'm going to lead you in a prayer. If you're in the auditorium, you say, Pastor, here is my hand. I've written my hand now for the resurrected Christ, for salvation. Would you do that right now? Would you lift your hand and say, here is my hand, Pastor. Today is my day. I'm going to lead in that prayer for those of you who are alive. If you want to be saved, say this prayer. Father, I thank you for the resurrection of Christ. Because he lives, I can live. I know that I'm a sinner. I can't save myself. And I ask forgiveness of my sin. I repent of my sin and I trust in Christ for salvation and eternal life. And from today onward, I will serve you until I see my Savior face to face in Christ's name. Amen. Amen. Praise God. For those who said that prayer, send us a shout out. Amen. We're going to open up the prayer lines and we're going to be praying for you a special resurrection prayer this morning, whatever it is in your life because of the resurrection. You are promised the victory, praise God. Amen. You're not feeling well in your body? Experience this morning the power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead. Glory to God. Believe and trust God for a breakthrough today. This is a very special day, special anointing. Would you please stand with me? The ministers of music, would you come? Amen. And lead us as we pray with the people. Glory to God. Amen. Children, remember, don't leave until you get your baskets, amen, of goodies. And we're back here 6:30 for that special evening service. Amen. Hallelujah.
Believe in the sun. Hallelujah. Father, we give you thanks and we give you praise, oh God. Lord, we bless your holy name, Lord Jesus. We thank you, God, Father, Lord, for the resurrection power this morning, oh God. Father, for Lord, we know, God, Father, Lord, you, oh God, have laid down your life, oh God, Father, so that we, oh God, can be lifted up, Lord, Father, so that we can be with you, oh God, for eternity, oh God. Father, and we thank you this morning for your great sacrifice, Lord. Lord, as we, Lord, surround, oh God, Father, Lord, Lord, as we are gathered here, oh God, amongst each other, Lord, Father, to celebrate, oh God, Father, the resurrection, oh God, Father, Lord, what you have done for us, Lord Jesus. Lord, Lord, we can never repay you, oh God. Father, Lord, we know, oh God, Father, Lord, it's only because of your love, oh God. Father, there's nothing that we can do or that we cannot do, oh God. Lord, that you, oh Lord, will love us more or less, Lord Jesus. Father, for Lord, your love is unconditional, oh God. Lord, and we thank you, God, for this love this morning, oh God. Lord, we thank you, oh God, that you, oh God, have, Lord, rescued us, oh God, out of the miry clay, oh God, and brought us into your glorious light, Lord Jesus. Lord, we thank you, God, that you, oh God, will continually, oh God, be with us, oh God, Father, as you have promised us in your word, oh God. Lord, that you will be with us until the end of the age, oh God. Lord, and we know, God, Father, Lord, that you have given us your spirit, oh God. You have not left us, oh God, Father, Lord, powerless, oh God. You have given us the spirit of power, oh God, Father, Lord, to continue to walk this walk, oh God. To continue, oh God, Father, to bring honor and glory to your name. Father, to those that doesn't know you, oh God, Father, we pray for them in a special way this morning, oh God. Lord, that you, oh God, will draw them unto yourself, oh God, Father, Lord, that they will come to know the true and the living God, Father, the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Father, for Lord, you are the good shepherd, oh God. Lord, as we know, God, that, Lord, it's not your desire that any man should perish, oh God. Father, but Lord, that all come to repentance, oh God, that all come to the foot of the cross. Hallelujah. So, Lord, we pray for them, Lord, that you, oh God, Father, Lord, touch them, that you bring conviction, Lord, whatever circumstances, Lord, whatever, Lord, situation they might be in this morning, Lord, that you, oh God, will use this as a tool, oh God, to draw them unto yourself, that, Lord, that you will open their eyes this morning, oh God, Father, Lord, that they will see, oh God, Father, that you are the only way, the truth, and you are the life, oh God. So, Lord, we just commit them into your hands. Lord, we lift up our nation this morning, oh God. Yeah. Lord, that they, oh God, will turn, oh God, Father, from their wicked ways, oh God. Father, Lord, that they, oh God, will hear your voice, oh God, calling out to them, Lord. And that they, oh God, will also come to know you, oh Lord Jesus. Yeah. Father, for Lord, you, oh God, are worthy, oh God, of all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory. Yeah. Lord, we pray, God, that you continue to be with us. Continue to empower us, oh God. To serve you, O God, wholeheartedly, O God, to seek you, O God, diligently, Lord Jesus. So, Father, we thank you, God. We give you all the praise, all the honor, all the glory, O God. And we just pray, God, and we ask, O God, that you continue to be with us, O God. Continue, O God, to go before us, O God, and just prepare the way for us, O God. So, Father, have your divine will in your way this morning. Take charge and take control. Be with your people. Bless your people, O God. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. Amen.